When it happens at a very young age, obviously it's extremely distressing. Often there are young children, then there people are working, and it has, you know, a major effect on the family, as it does in later age, but even more so when people are no longer able to work and when they start to decline in their cognitive abilities. One of the problems is that it often is a more aggressive disease because it means that it's starting about 20 or 25 years earlier. And that means that often people progress more quickly than the later onset, although there's a lot of individual variability. In terms of what can be done, we try the same medications that we use for regular Alzheimer's disease because some of the same chemical deficiencies develop, involving some important neurochemicals. However, we still are really in the early stages of developing what we call disease-modifying therapies, and we don't really have treatments that are approved or properly developed yet. There may be hope in younger onset patients because there is a little more known about specific subgroups like Down syndrome or people who have the genetic mutations that may allow them to actually get access to treatments that are developmental right now. They're experimental, but if they work, might really change the future of individuals with those conditions.